Welcome back to the lab, guys. Today we are taking a look at EG4's 3-kilowatt all-in-one off-grid inverter. This is the 3000EHV-48, which is a mouthful and it sounds very confusing, but this is actually a super beginner-friendly unit. It's relatively new in the EG4 lineup and it offers some really good features for the money. This is a really good value purchase. Today we're gonna go through all the specs on this guy. We're gonna show you guys the things that we like, some of the things we don't like. We're gonna install it and we're gonna run it through some basic tests to find out if this is the inverter for you. And as always, you guys know that here at the lab, our opinions cannot be bought. If you want to check this thing out at any point during the video, we will leave some links in the description. Signature Solar was actually nice enough to give us a coupon code for this. I know you guys are always hounding us for discounts. No one ever wants to give them to us. Is the code gonna make you feel like you won the lottery? No. But it's 50 bucks off of a purchase over $500, which this is, so 50 bucks is 50 bucks. But first up, let's jump into a super quick 60-second spec teardown to get everybody familiar with the EG4 3K inverter. First up, this Pikachu passes the tiny baby lift test. It only weighs 19 pounds, which is really good for all you old folks trying to put this thing up on a wall. This is a single phase 120 volt unit, but you can run 240 if you have two of them, and you can actually stack up to 12 of these inverters, and you can get it up to 36 kilowatts of output. It's a 3000 watt pure sine wave inverter, and it's rated at 94% efficiency. It has a super impressive solar input of 5000 watts with a working voltage of 120 to 500. It also has a really impressive 80 amp AC input. In terms of the screen on this guy, it is super clean, crisp, and easy to read. And then looking around at the rest of this unit's build in general, you have a fan on each side. And on the bottom, super simple, you have your on and off switch, you have a breaker, you have your ground screw right here, you have communication port, generator on and off, and then you have a solar input, an AC out, an AC in, and you also have your battery positive and negative cables on the other side over here. It's a relatively clean and simple unit. In terms of the app for this unit, it sucks. It's not good. And you can get all of this for $750 or 700 if you use the code. Oh, I never even told them the code. What's the code? The Solar Lab 50. And we've actually also seen it on sale recently. So I don't know if you could stack that coupon code, but if you can, woo, good deal. So jumping into some of the things that we really, really like about this little 3-kilowatt EG4 inverter, starting with the 5,000 watt solar input. That's really impressive for a unit of this size to do 5,000 watts, and the working voltage is 120 to 500. In lamest terms, basically means it's gonna be super easy to get power into this. You're not gonna need a combiner box or anything crazy, just some panels in series into this and you will be good to go. A lot of the other units like this Rich Solar one on the wall behind me, the working voltage for the same, pretty much the same solar input is like 60 to 120 max. So that gets a lot more complicated when you're trying to figure out how to put 4,000 or 5,000 watts of solar into a unit, but you have to stay within a very tight voltage restriction. Next up, we really just like that this unit is so beginner friendly and it's not daunting at all. A lot of times, especially like if you look underneath the faceplate of this Rich inverter, for example, you can see like everything is right there and it can be really daunting to someone that is brand new to this. This unit under the faceplate is so clean. They basically hid everything from you, so you can't poke around where you're not supposed to be poking around. And they basically made it look and feel just very easy for beginners. And I also really like that it just came with the wires, and it came with the wires that have the little crimps on the end. They slide right in, they tighten up snug. Very minimal work has to go in by the person installing it, which then just makes everybody's life way happier. And that goes hand in hand with being extremely easy to actually set up and install. Literally just throw it on the wall, plug in what you need to plug in, go through your settings, select your battery type, and you're pretty much done. And the last thing that I really like is that there is air filters on both sides of the top of this unit. So while these things aren't rated to be outside in the rain, if you have this in like a workshop, even just like a camper that you have the doors open and there's dirt and stuff in the air that's going through these units, having the little filters will expand the life and longevity of this thing tenfold. Which bleeds us into some of the things that we don't like about this inverter. And the first one is that it's not the quietest inverter out there, and that is because it has to pull air through these filters. There's some other units on the market that don't have filters, and if you're running them in a relatively clean environment, the fans make a lot less noise because they have to work a lot less to actually get air to go through them. It's not that loud. Like I wouldn't complain about it, but for someone that has never had any of this gear before or puts this accidentally close to a place that they're gonna be sitting or sleeping or whatever, and they don't have experience with these yet, you do hear it. So that's just something to know. It's better than a lot of other units we've seen, but it's not as good as some of the other units we've also seen. Was that English?
Seen that.
Yeah, we've seen a little bit of everything. I also don't like that with this unit, we got it in a kit from Signature Solar with panels and a lot of the jazz that you see on the wall behind me. We're trying to work on a little project here in the garage where we kind of just take the whole garage off grid. Besides the point, this came with instructions for it specifically, but if you buy it in a kit, there's no like install instructions. And I found that a little weird. We knew how to set everything up. We knew where everything goes, but it comes with a bus bar, a fuse, wires, and all these things that if you aren't familiar, they don't have their own instructions to tell you where everything goes in line. Each component that we got came with its own user manual, but there was no instruction from Signature Solar on how each component actually goes together. Now, while that's not necessarily specific to this inverter, it's just something to note. $50 that they're taking off the price is the $50 that they didn't pay someone to make a little pamphlet for you to actually know how to install it. And the last thing that I really don't like about this inverter, or at least the Wi-Fi dongle that it comes with, is the app. It's the Smart ESS app. It's not even like an EG4 specific app. We've actually had this app for other units in the past. Historically, like power stations have really good apps. This kind of stuff doesn't have as good of apps. I didn't even get it completed because after like half an hour of messing with it, it was thinking that the whole thing was a storage system, and I couldn't figure out how to make it think that it was also an inverter and show me what was going on. I wasn't having fun. I bailed. I think that's also specific to the dongle that you get, what app you get. So it might be worth noting to look at a different dongle. In terms of the install and the setup on this bad boy, it was so easy. It has the two screw mounts on top, so it's as simple as just firing two screws into the wall, hanging it, and then putting a final one in the slot underneath just to make sure that it doesn't pop off. But like I've been saying, underneath this faceplate, everything makes a lot of sense. So I went ahead and shoved the battery connections up in there, which is super easy to do. Like I said, these wires come with like the little square crimp on the end. And when it comes to the AC out, there's actually a ground screw underneath this unit. It might be easier to see right here. This is where they want you to ground the AC out. I didn't want to ground it there because that looks ugly, to be honest with you, that's why. And then there's a ground behind the faceplate that says it's for the AC in, but if you actually go ahead and take this front facing cover off, that other ground just grounds to the frame of the unit anyways. So they both ground to the same place. I chose to use the one on the inside, even though I'm about to get blasted by all of the electricians as to why I shouldn't have done that. And we never burned anything down yet. Wired in the solar input. These wires run outside to a small array we have. Anyways, it's that simple. And then we ran an AC out. We literally just, for testing purposes, we just used an extension cord that we snipped the end off of, run everything in for the AC in, go ahead, plug that into a 120 outlet from the house. And that is how you get some power into this. And then in terms of setup, go ahead and throw this thing on, hold down the enter button for like 2-3 seconds or whatever. It takes you into a menu. The only thing that you really need to change to get going is just the battery. You can go to, I think it's setting 5. You go to lithium for EG4 battery. We were using EG4 LL batteries. Something that was weird though, I was actually getting like a really weird error code with this. And then I found out that you have to run the main battery as an AGN, which is just like a weird little informational piece, but. So the only other thing that you actually have to do is the communication port underneath here. You gotta plug that cable from the battery to this, and that lets them communicate properly because the battery has a battery monitoring system built into it. So it actually can kill the inverter if it needs to protect itself for any reason. There's no crazy settings or programming or anything that needs to go on other than the battery selection, but there is a ton you can do in here. And when it comes to testing, we ran this thing through some light basic tests. Starting with the idle consumption. Now this thing is loud when you plug it in. It's not loud, but you can hear it. You know it's running. And so right away, you know it's consuming some amount of power. An inverter like this, when it's not on standby, when it's just on the wall on, and you have, like we do, outlets wired right underneath it, those outlets always have power, same way the outlets at your house always have power. So this is gonna be always consuming some power from the battery regardless, because it's just waiting for you to plug something in. So with this unit, we were seeing on the battery's monitor actually about 1.2 to 1.3 amps. So we rounded that up in the middle, 1.25. So these are 51.2 volt batteries. So it was consuming about 64 watts on idle, which is higher than I would have expected for a tiny little unit like this. You can turn the inverter off and you can set standby modes and all that kind of stuff, but if it's just on, even if you're not using power, you're using 64 watts. In terms of the load test, this is a 3000 watt output. I actually ran it just over 3000 watts for like 15 or 20 minutes and it never complained once. So that's really good to know. Even if you accidentally just a little bit go over, you're still gonna be okay. And when it came to surge capacity, it ran the surge for about 10 seconds, I think. The AC input, I actually couldn't get it to the rated amperage because I kept blowing the fuse in the house. I didn't have the right gauge wire going into it, but it's hungry, it wants to take it. And in terms of pass-through, to me, this is something that's actually really important. So if you run completely out of batteries and you have solar plugged into this or the utility, because the utility could also be like a generator. So say this is at your off-grid cabin and you just run out of batteries. You haven't had sun, your batteries are completely dead. Now the sun comes out, solar is putting 2000 watts into this. Can you use that 2000 watts without the batteries at all? And so for this test, I literally shut the breakers off on the batteries. Now, obviously our utility input and our solar input is not at the maximum, but I was able to keep this thing running and still run an AC load and a similar test with the solar, which is really good. You can go in here and set your settings to whichever one you want to prioritize. But at the end of the day, just know that if you run out of batteries, if you're getting power from somewhere, whether that's a generator or the sun or whatever, you can just pass that power right on through. And if you're getting 2000 watts of solar and you're running a 1000 watt load, the other 1000 watts will go ahead and start charging your batteries. So overall, even though the app is no bueno and this thing looks like a Pikachu, it's a killer unit for the price. It's beginner friendly. It does exactly what it needs to do. And EG4 is a really good and reputable name. Like I said, we have some links down below if you guys want to grab 50 bucks off of this unit from Signature Solar. And if you don't actually know if this is the best unit for you, you can just call them and ask and they can hook you up with a unit that actually fits your needs, because I know that it's one thing to watch YouTube videos on units and things all day long, and it's another one to actually spend your hard-earned money on something that suits your needs. That is all we got for you guys. I will catch you guys next time. Thank you guys so much for watching. Peace out and stay charged.